Yeah, hi Omkar. We just start, about to start.
I just one thing from yesterday's session I wanted to check. So local setup, is that something we are covering right now or कैसे करना है?
For PDF service, we are covering local setup today.
So
PDF.
Vipin, any update from you guys? Infra, have at least one environment has it been set up?
Yeah, Pradeep, yeah, this is what I was trying to. Actually, the pods are running. That's the state from yesterday, but I'm unable to understand what configuration is missing or what URLs to hit. So that is what I requested in the start of the session just before you joined. At least give me some URLs or something which I can test up, or some configuration missing or something. Something is definitely missing. I do not know, but all the pods are running. That is there.
All the pods are running
We
and
will
all
help you
the.
out, Aniket, after this session, probably 15 minutes. That
Yeah,
citizen
I think you guys can resolve it
will.
in 5-10 minutes. It's
Yes.
not a time consuming job also.
Actually, we'll get someone from Impel also so that they can give the seed employees and all those scripts.
I'm not sure the DB and all, how you have
Yeah,
loaded any
that's the issue.
employees?
No, I do not
So
have that data
actually,
also.
someone from Impel can help
Okay.
you to set up the basic
Yeah.
stuff like base employees and all those.
No, so anyways, I have organized one session with Nitin today,
Okay.
Pradeep.
Okay,
So
okay, okay.
if there are any infra related issues, please keep them ready. What
Yeah.
we'll do is we'll have one session with Nitin and get them resolved. But
Yeah.
yeah, so you're saying at least the core infra part is up and running, right? Pods are up and
Core
running.
and all the services, even the images which were shared are running.
So playground images you have already deployed.
Yeah. All the services also. You have eGov, MDMS, print, PDF and everything. This HRMS, ID gen, indexer, localization, OTP, persister.
We will do one thing. After this session, probably, I'll get you in touch with Malati for half an hour. She'll just give you the payload to create employee.
Yeah, but the URLs also are not hitting. That's the point. From the ingress,
I think he's on one step before creating the users actually.
Role action mappings and all that will have to add before MDMS data will have to load. Then we can
Maybe even before that, Aniket, I think so his point is that what, see, we are accessing the environment using domains, right? So we have
Yeah, there's no domain here.
eGov-micro. So that's what. So that is something which we'll first have to figure out before with DevOps, and then because he needs endpoints to hit in order to load employees and all these things, right? So
Yeah,
those
for now,
endpoints.
Pradeep, you can port forward and check. We can do after this session, we can explore.
Even Omkar, that point, na, MDMS hit service and all. So please share the Postman collection of all the required services, okay? Because Malti was telling that she will share it, but we don't have the direct interaction with her. So please.
So I think I've already shared one for localization. I'll also get others from our end share. Thanks. Go ahead.
So hi everyone. So today I will be talking about the PDF service. So basically, I will start with the API call, then I will tell about the configuration files, and we'll go with the local setup. So in PDF service, generally it is in a service to create a PDF as per our requirement. So there are three API calls are there: create no save, and the search call. The create and the create no save both are the same. The difference is only that the create call will generate the PDF and save the file store ID into the database, while the create no save doesn't save the ID into the database. And the parameters for the create call are the key and the tenant ID. The key basically are the templates which we are going to write for the our PDF. So to creating a PDF, basically there are two main files are required: data config file and the format config file. You can find that both the file in the config repo. I will share the link of the repo later on. So I will just show you. In this repo, in PDF service, these two folder, data config and format config. So actually these two files are main crux for the PDF service to generate a PDF. So the two config file, format config and the data config file, the format config file is used to define the how the PDF will look like. Means basically define the UI structure of a PDF. And the data config file is generally used to map the values to that UI structures. So we are using the two external libraries, that is PDF make and Mustache. The PDF make is generally for the format, means to define the UI structure, CS stylings and all for that PDF. And that Mustache is for mapping that value that we give JSON as an input. We give JSON as an input and map that value to that particular PDF structure. I will show you a structure of a PDF, how it would look like. So basically, this is the format config. The main part is key here, which defines, means that the name of a template. Means if we in the API call, if we mention that key name, the PDF server will fetch this template for a PDF. And the two main part are the content and the style. Content generally contain the UI structure of a PDF, what it contains, means like tables, data, text and all. And the style is for to style that all that content. So basically we can have an footer or a header or tables and the columns that what we want to have in a PDF, you all have to write here. So all the structure, how to write a table and all, we can find it from the PDF make org. Basically we are using the PDF make org syntax and templates for it. So I'll show you the call. This is create no save. And here we are going to call on the trade license receipt. So basically the PDF service will fetch this template. Fetch this template from the config repo and from the data config file, actually it's match that JSON value and map it to the format file. And generate the PDF like this one. So I will go one by one for the how the data config is written and the format config is written. So for the data config part, there are three main mappings. That is a direct mapping, derived mapping, and the external mapping. Direct basically for the PDF service, the inputs are that JSON, just like this is a payment JSON. So from this payment JSON, we fetch the value and map into that UI template, means format file. So in data config, there are three mapping: direct, derived, and external. In direct mapping, we define the variables and labels. So for defining a variable, this is the format for it. So we define a variable name and we mention the path, like a dollar dot pair name, like dollar dot username dot name. It basically map that value and assign that value to that variable. And same when the PDF service is called, the same value will get replaced here in that UI file.
So this one is data file. Previous one was the format file, right?
Yeah. This one right now is the format file, and this one is the data file. So data file generally get the mappings and map into the format UI using the Moustache template. So direct mapping generally get that value from the input. This one is the input, and in derive mapping. Just a second. Yeah, in derive mapping, what are the variable we are declare into the direct section, we can use that variable to format another variable by performing the action like arithmetic operation, plus, minus, division, and multiplication. We can have another value. And the another mapping is an external mapping. External mapping is generally used when we want that some value which are not from the input, but from the one of the value, we can call that other services and have that value and use in our PDF service. So basically in external API here, now we are use that MDMS call to get that values like header and footer, the ULB details, this one. This all we get from the MDMS data. So path we generally mention that basic MDMS call, then we mention that what are the filters are in the query param, and the response we get the same. We mention that variable name and the JSON part to get the value and map it to that variable. So in a data config, we can have a value variable, we can have a label variable, and we can have a date variable. So I will show you how that all this is done. So basically this is the value variable. We get the value from that input, and this is the label variable, which is same as in a value variable, but the difference is we have to mention a type as a label. For most of the label in the PDF service are defined into the localization. So in PDF services also support the localization, only we have to mention a flag of it that the require is true, and mention is module name. Also in some of that data we get from that input, also the localization is required. So for such a value variable, we have to mention the prefix, because in input file we only get half of that localization code. So to get the full code, we have to mention a prefix to it. So it calls that localization service and get the whole message, and it get assigned to that variable, and it map to the it is a map in a format UI. Another variable type is the date type. This same as the other one, only we have to mention a type as a date, as it is used as a flag. And basically when we mention the type as a date, the format for it is date, month, and a year. But it is a default set. Or if you want to mention the your specific format, let's say you have to write a format and the format for it, whatever you want is like year come first, month, and date. Basically, here you can define your own format for the date you want to have in the PDF server, in your PDF.
Rohit, in case of customer localization, right, you are you're saying the prefix will be there. Okay. And what about the prefix plus something? That part, can you explain it more?
Yeah, sure. So for example, just a minute, we'll find a variable like this one, service type. So in service type, for this business service in input, yeah, see, Here we get the input as a TL. So basically, from the JSON part, we get the value as a TL. But in the localization database, the code for the TL services is mentioned with module underscore TL. So for that, to get the whole code, we have to mention the prefix here. So we mention the prefix here, the whole code will be module underscore TL, and it will search into the localization service, into the database, and get the message. And that module underscore TL, the message is trade license service. So that value is get assigned to the variable service type.
What about the module in this?
This module is generally we store that all localization into some module. You're asking about this module?
This module. No.
Key
as a module.
For every service, we define a localization in some modules over there.
Okay.
So for example, this module underscore TL is present in this module. This module means in the sense this folder in database.
So Vipin, it's like grouping we do to serve localization. So that TL localization will be in module called Rainmaker-TL. Property will be in Rainmaker-PT, like this grouping. So that each service will just search for its own localization rather than other services.
Okay. Normally you doesn't give with the Rainmaker underscore. So that's what I got confused. Mean normally you give the service name, particular service name, right?
Yeah, means we didn't actually follow any convention. Basically, okay. UI put Rainmaker-TL, we just followed the same.
Okay. Okay.
Basically, most of the labels are in the Rainmaker common module. So that's why all that labels for the PDF are mentioned in the Rainmaker common module.
So which is like Rainmaker common module, it's part of some service or it's a part of this PGR service means?
No, basically.
Rainmaker common, where is this folder exists actually? In which service?
So sorry, I don't have any much idea of it.
Okay. Is it the localization service? I'm guessing it is in the localization service.
So in it's localization service, Rainmaker-Common will contain whatever UI requires for common screens, like for payment and all those screens, which are common across modules. So whatever localizations they require for those screens, they will store with a group called as Rainmaker-Common. So basically localization services are like, it's a key value. It stores the key value where keys, the backend code and values, whatever you want to display on UI. So, and module is just a grouping.
Okay. This Rainmaker common, is it used only for PDF generation or is required in any other?
That module might have other localizations also, whatever are required by UI on common pages.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
So this PGR is in core, right? It's a part of core service.
Yeah. PGR is a part of our municipal services. PGR, PT, means business services.
Business service, okay. We just want to check this folder with...
it's mostly a part of UI. Everything. It's not a backend service. Rainmaker-Common.
Okay. Yeah. So this module underscore TL will give the response of the service type, right? The response will be mapped to the service type. The prefix that is mentioned, module, and the TL comes, and it will be appended as module underscore TL, right?
Yeah. It will be like.
And the response that comes will be mapped to the variable service type.
Yeah.
So that mapping where it is mentioned.
When the value is assigned to the variable service type, then it will be mapped into the format file service type here. So this is in the UI structure. For example, in a particular table, the value will be appear here.
Okay.
So for example. So this is the position of that value. So that value will be appear here. basically it is in a UI format of in a PDF.
Okay.
So yeah, and for the format config, the main section are the content and the style, where you mention a table or a text and all, and for that component you style them. For example, this is a structure how you define a table into the format file. Like table, you are giving a width over there, where the width will define in a particular row what is the width of in a each column over there, and we define that each row into the body section. So this, for example, in this body section I have mentioned, okay, so in this body section, yeah, yeah, so basically in the body array, this single element is defined as in a one row, wherein one row we define that each column over there, like this one. So basically these are the labels, and this is the value assigned to it. And like a receipt number, then its value, then a consumer ID, then its value. It's all appear in a single row, as you can see in that. This one, receipt number, then its value, then application number label, then its value. So for same in the same table in another row, payment date in its value, then label payer name, then its value. So it's all defined in a one table of it. So this one is the first row, then this one is the second row, and the payment date and its value and all. So this is how we mention a table over there. And to style that table, we mention a flag or a key over here, style with a name, and that is defined into the style array for the same file, the style section, like in receipt. So for this one, we have mentioned before that whoever have the style value, whatever the color, whether it is a bold or not, what the font size of an each text, font width, and some margin over there.
Okay.
So basically these are the two main file that we use for the PDF generation. So after create, so I will tell you, you can use the PDF make org while creating this format file. Basically it will be easy to create this file while we are creating a file and see the result at both the time. So you can use this PDF make org. You have to from that format file, you have to mention only that contain and style part of it. You edit and you edit it according to your requirement, and it will appear into the result on the right hand side. So it will give a feel of the effects of what are the happen in the code. I mean in the config file. So I will now go with that local setup of it. So right now, any doubt in this?
Actually, in your JSON configuration data format is a data format. The where we are actually fetching the values from the service, okay, based on dollar and this way. So in that, yeah, you have mentioned this, like for localization, you are calling the services, okay? So in that, it's a local host 8761, some port you have defined it. And we just wanted to be sure that, will it be part of, like when we say the deployment, it will get updated along with the YAML, or it will always be hitting the same port?
And so when
you call the service, means in the JSON you have defined the service call, right?
Mm-hmm.
So when the deployment starts,
in JSON, in this file we didn't write about
somewhere
the localization.
Somewhere we call the service. Somewhere we call the service, right? In this.
I think it is in the other file. Format config, I guess.
No, it's not in format config. It's in the PDF service. Here we call that localization service here. So basically, calling the localization message is done in the PDF service, not into the config file.
Actually, in that localization, we at the end external URL is there. Can you open that?
Okay.
External part was there, third part.
External API, I guess.
External API.
Yeah. In that, this path is mentioned, right? Path equal to something, right? So when we start the deployment, does it this part get updated or it always be the same path only?
Yeah, this path will be same, right? MDMS, tenant ID, and address.
No.
This path will be same.
Line number 398. Line number 398.
Path will change because all our internal calls goes through http://servicename:8080 Zul reroutes it, right? So we'll have to put that path here.
Okay, you are talking about this one, right? Okay. Actually, you are talking about this one. Right. I only write it for that pointing it to that port. So to show into the local. So basically it will be that pod ID actually.
Okay. So once the deployment happens, all this path also gets updated, right?
Yeah. Okay. It will be appear like this one.
Okay.
Like this. It's a ego MDMS service. This pod will be there. 8080. I just mentioned it here to demo in a local. That's how pointed to the pod. Yeah.
Okay. And the second thing, previously I was asking rainmaker.com and dash common. If you can later tell me like where actually the file will be, because we have to do the mapping of this localization while doing the PDF generation. So I'll be able to map that part. Okay. So when in localization module underscore TL, where we mention in that below that the next line was module equal to rainmaker underscore dash common, right?
Yeah.
So where actually this file will be there, this file.
Yeah, actually, it is not a file, it is a grouping in a database, that, like what Anikita said.
So we store it in DB. We can give you the DB dump for that.
This is a table name, actually.
Yeah, it's so module is actually one column. In localization, there will be three columns. Means the three important columns will be first will be module, which is the super category. Second is the key that is the localization key, and third is the message. What message you want to display for that key? So what happens like when I need some in TL service, if I need to search some specific localization, I will just fetch all the localization belonging to the module TL, so that I don't have to then again fill. Means I just take a subset of data required for that particular service rather than all service.
Sorry, I didn't get it.
It's just a super class, means categorization, you can say.
Right.
Vipin, is it clear or?
I'm not getting a means how this module is getting mapped with a database table, or it's a database table or class name or JSON file.
Okay. Rohit, just share the PG. You have PG admin, right?
No, I don't have
installed. Just open your localization message table and show how the entries are stored.
Just a minute. DB access.
Local you will be having, right? Don't use that one.
No, I don't have a local in message, and in local I don't have a message table.
Okay.
So basically, Vipin, there's in a table that module is a column name, not a table name.
Okay.
So basically, in a table, a table like message localization message, there are three column, important column, module, and the key and the message. So basically, when we mention that module name and we have a key, so it will be easy to fetch the record from the database.
Okay, got it.
So it's like
rather than searching 10 keys, we just search the module and we fetch all the 10 keys by searching on module directly.
Okay.
In this case, Rainmaker Common is one of the entry in the module column.
Yeah.
What is the key used for this?
What
key is used to get the value?
For example, I want to
share my screen. I will share.
Rohit, I have sent you the table structure. You can open Slack.
Yeah, for the for this message table, there's a column like ID, local, message, module, and all. So basically, that module is one of the column name.
That is understood. We need one more key. I think key is corresponding to the code, right?
Code key is corresponding to the code.
If you go to the can you just go there to the configuration file? Where have you mentioned which key, used as a key?
Yeah, for example, there are two different things. First, the label part. For the label part, this whole thing is a key.
Okay.
And for the other one, where we get a half value from the input and the half we have to mention the prefix one, like that service type, right?
Okay.
So when we mention the prefix as a module and whatever the value we get here, like this one, here the value is TL.
Okay.
Right. So the whole code will be become module underscore TL. This is the whole code, and it query with the module name as a Rainmaker Common, and it's give the message.
Okay.
You got it, na?
Code
is module underscore TL, and the module name is Rainmaker Common, and it gave that message value.
Okay.
So yeah, this thing. So what I was telling it, you can use that PDF make playground environment for your testing your format file. So now I'll go with that local setup. So before that, any other question?
Actually, I'm getting confused over this module part. In the database, the module name will be stored as property tags TL, like that, right?
No, it's for localization. We are not talking about that module. This is the localization message which is used for all screen. If we mention the Rainmaker Common, means it will be used for that localization message for every common pages. For example, if you mention the Rainmaker TL, it will be used for the TL module only. If you mention the module name as a Rainmaker PT, so all the localization message will be used for the module property service. So here, okay, module means that
during
thing.
Localization, we are in the DB in one of the column. We are saving it as what? Can you show so that?
In my local, I don't have that table. That's why. So Aniket, can you show it?
Yeah, let me show. So these entries will be there. So this is the code. Then whatever message the UI want to show corresponding to this code, and this is the module name. So what will happen is when someone enters the PT module through UI, the UI will search all the localization codes belonging to this rainmaker-pt module. So whatever codes and messages will be there will be fetched by the UI. Then wherever at whatever page you navigate, it will use this code to fetch the corresponding message.
Okay. So code-wise module, yeah, it will be stored, right?
Yeah, yeah. The and the TL underscore module is just a convention that we are using to save these messages.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. So any other out? So I will go with the local setup now. So we'll find that PDF service, the core service.
Rohit, your screen is not visible.
Okay, yes. Yeah, you'll find the PDF service in the core service. Clone it. So before starting the PDF service, you have to start the means you can point out to the other service, localization service and the file store service. So for to run in the local, basically you have to port forward it to the service in a particular environment. So right now port forward into the QA environment. And you have to mention the file path of that both data on data config file and the format config file here. So before running, you have to install the npm into that directory. So basically, I have created a file for it. I will share it to you after this session. Basically, it contains all that what are the step and the command that is required for the local setup. Just go through it before you're running this PDF service into the local.
The development environment is Ubuntu, right? Or
Ubuntu.
Windows will also.
Yeah, for Windows you can mention the file name. Same, no changes.
Okay.
Just a minute. Yeah, so here after installing the npm into that directory, you have to run the npm run dev command. So you'll see in the log all that file will be loaded, data file and the format file. So as I mentioned, there are three APIs: create, search, and the create no save. So for that, input our request info and that particular JSON one for that trade license or any other template. So in data file, if there are some external service you have mentioned, so that link is that service also had to port forward there. So into the format config, into the data config, you have to port forward it, like I mentioned it here, like localhost 8071 and like this. I'm calling the same service, MDMS service.
So your MDMS service is running in your local system, right? Or
no, system, I'm port forwarding. So like this, I get the port IDs and port forward.
Oh, okay.
This is the command, ctl,
okay.
Port forward, and that port ID and the whatever the port number you want. So this is here, a port forwarding the MDMS service.
Okay.
Yeah. So all the three services, like a localization, then file store service, and the MDMS service.
Okay.
So basically, in that from these two service only, we have used the create service. We don't use the create no service into the QA or dev environment. So create no service is generally for us to develop to test our created config only. So here we mention the input here and we hit the API. So this is what we get the output. This is all the data from the header. All the header data get from the MDMS. This is the middle part from the what are the input we get, and this all the footer data get from the MDMS also. This is the result of the create no save API. So for a create API, we get the PDF is generated and it get downloaded into the S3 server, and as the result we get the FileStore ID of it, like this one. And using this FileStore ID, by calling to the FileStore URL service, we can get the URL of it. So creates API generally create the PDF and save into the S3, and gave us the link, FileStore ID, which is assigned to that URL. So we can use this URL to download the PDF.
Rohit, where we are having the scenario like when we want to save and create and save, and only create part.
No, actually create no save, we are for the developer only, means for to check into the our local system. We don't use create no save in any UI.
Okay.
Yeah, we only use create service. Create API call. Create no save is for our developer to test the config we have created.
Okay.
Actually these two endpoints are for different requirements. Like sometimes we want to store it on FileStore, and later we want to search it so that we don't do repeatedly same work. So in that scenarios, we can use create endpoint. And if you just want to download PDF and don't want to store anywhere, then we can use create no save.
Right. Obviously, in the production environment, you want to save some particular things, and is this something which is given by the client, or you only taking a cautious call that it has to be persisted into S3 bucket, or it's simply, for example, receipt. Both the cases, it has generated a receipt. So whether we should save in database or not, again, retrieval part comes. In what case we are doing this means? One part you told that developer part, for developer case, we should not use the create file. Otherwise, it will store something in data S3 bucket. But in the production time, means it will be a use case for the complete project.
For production part, depend on the what's the client requirement is. If you want to just show the PDF, not get downloaded, we can go with the create no save.
Right. Means both the things, means even if we store it, even we don't store it, it's taking very less time to regenerate it. So when we are having a specific requirement to store along with the creating.
Oh, sorry, I didn't get you on this one.
So currently, we are not storing on production.
Okay.
Okay, so thus search API call search the PDF based on the two part, entity ID and the job ID. So entity ID is the thing which we have mentioned into the config file. So this key is used to indicate which template has to use, and the entity ID is generally used for the search one. For the example, whatever the ID values get is it will map to the entity path which is used for the search purpose, and the other thing we get during the create call is the job ID. So using the job ID, we can search our PDF. So it's generally return only the FileStore ID only. So you can use this FileStore ID to get that URL and download the PDF. So basically, these are the three calls for it. Local setup and the configuration for the PDF service. Any other doubt?
No. So we'll be getting some time to do this local setup and check one time, right?
Sorry, I didn't
have means, it. Whatever the you are going to share one document, so we also will try this in local setup.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, we can ping us whenever you get stuck in anything.
Yeah.
Okay.
So basically, this document is shared with you, right? This PDF conference document.
Confluence document is shared. You are saying one more document, no?
That document link is mentioned here. This step for video generation is locally.
Okay. Okay.
Mention is here. Path is mentioned here.
Okay.
Okay. Fine. So can we proceed with the report service? So any other doubt before proceeding the report service?
This file store is in the AWS, right? Or when you say local setup, is it somewhere locally hosted in your?
No. I'm just pointing it to the environment in QA environment. So that file store service is using
AWS only.
AWS only, not in the local one.
Okay.
Okay, so can I proceed with the report service?
Yeah.
So, Gopesh?
Yeah. Okay. Rohit, can you stop presenting? So my screen is visible now. Hello.
Yes,
So yesterday I talked about this report config and endpoints. So today I will discuss about local setup. So like I explained earlier, like for any report we have some config like this. For each of the report, so here in source columns, we define what columns we want to show to the user, and in search params we define the parameters on which the user can search. So basically, based on search columns, this card is drawn, and there is this base query, and group by clause, order by clause, and all that. So I will proceed with the setup thing. So the code of report service can be found from core service repo. From here we can find. So I have copied the same code and imported in this ID. So after that, we need to add the reports after configuring this, after installing this service. So here in this variable report location file path, I am pointing to the file where all the report URLs are mentioned. So this is the same file. Here I have defined all the reports that I am using. So these reports and this file is basically kept in this config repo. So in config repo, we keep out all the configs used in services for dev and QA environments. So for reports, we have kept it here. So this file is the same file. It contains URL for each of the reports, and the report definitions are kept here. So similar folder I have here in my local, and these are the reports, and this is that file. Same file URL I have copied here. Yeah. After copying that URL, I am I'm giving the name of the DB that I am using in my local. So this is the DB that I am using, and basically only this much configuration is required for running report. So after that configuration, I will run that report. So it will read all the reports, define that file. So it has read this report and TL report, all that. It has that. So for running in local, like sometimes we in our some of the reports we may be showing drop down menu. So sometimes we get that information from some other service, like MDMS service we are using here to get the list of all the ULBs. So that service host name we need to give, like either through port forwarding we will be getting the service, or when we'll be running in local. So that host name we need to give. So because I was running MDMS in my local, so I am giving that port number. So now this report setup is done, and what I am doing is I am running front end in my local machine and pointing this for report. I am pointing to this service. So here I am running this front end, and for report I am pointing to this service, and for access control also I am running in my local. So access control basically does this. It gives what all action items should be there in left menu. So yesterday I talked about, like, for any report we need to add two kind of entries in action menu. So first one is this one, like where we want to draw, and the second one here, like what URL we are using for that report. So now I have run this in my local machine. So if I reach to this, if any call to report service is made, so it will be redirected to this report service, and rest all call will be redirected to normal queue environment. So here I have loaded this report. So now this, since I am running all these things in local, I can quickly like test whatever changes I want to make and all that. So suppose I want to make this from column mandatory in this report. So I will just restart this report service.
Gopesh, so when you deploy the local part, you take one particular package and you start deploying that, right? Front end side.
Yeah, actually, I am running complete employee application here. At the Rainmaker level, I am running this command npm run dev employee.
Okay.
That command I am using this. That command.
And previously Rohit was also running like this only, or because in
that was backend only. His service was backend thing. This I am running this front end app. I am running
where he configured the environment variable .js file. So that part was front end only, right?
No, that was a backend, complete backend service.
So JS file.
PDF service we have wrote in Node.js.
Yeah.
Okay.
For this command I am running npm run dev employee to run this service. So now this is visible in the browser, and I can access the report based on the configurations I had defined there. So after I made the change, like make this column mandatory, So this is visible here. If I search without filling this information, I will get this error. So likewise, and also I can change the type of these search params. Like if I want it to be free text only, I will change it to a string. And here, instead of single drop down menu, if I want multi select also, then I will change this to multi select. So now this has become a free text, and here I can do multi select also. So like we can take make we can change the type of each of these search parameters, like string for free text, epoch for date field, and multi-select and single-select options. We can change here. Just by changing this type parameter, we can change the type of those parameters.
So Gopesh, epoch, string, single value list, multiple value list. Other than this, do we have anything else?
Number also.
Number,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
but it's mentioned as a part of your Confluence documentation. Means what and all combination we can use it.
Okay, I will check. It should be part of that thing. If it is not updated, I will check.
Okay.
Yeah. So this is the basic configuration. So like I will explain these two special cases, like multi-value. This is single value, multi-value list, and inline table. Those concept I will explain. So in multi-value list, we are fetching the code and value pairs, so that front end can. So the value will be what the front end will show to the user, and the code will be when the user selects that value, what would actually be sent to the backend side. So these code value pairs are used for that thing. So like for these, like syntax for multi value and single value is almost same thing. Just we have to change the type here. And here I am fetching this information from MDMS service and using this JSON path to get array of values with get array of object with the code and name fields. So for this single value or multi value list, we have to have a pair of code and actual value. Only then it will work. If we provide only one value, then it will not work. So here this is dynamic only. Like we are fetching from MDMS service. So sometimes we can hard code it also, like if we are sure that we want these values only. So for that, we can use pattern like this. Here we have defined the pattern as some service and then two JSON paths separated by this field. So if we are sure that we want to show only a certain number of fields, so we can write this like this only: list and code and value, code and value, code and value. So after, even in this external call also, the result will be the same thing only. It would be converted to the same thing Yeah, it's shown here. So, and one more thing in this inline tabling. So basically, most of the time we are fetching the data directly from DBO itself using from report service. Sometimes we need in any report we need to combine the data in the DB with the, some service like this localization thing or location data or MDMS, where the there is for localization we have DB. But for some MDMS or locations data coming from MDMS or location service, we can also use here. So for that, we will just write the API URL of that service, and from that response, whatever array we will be getting, that base array we will write here, and we will write the key names from that array, whatever we want to use in our table. Like here in message table, we want to use code and message fields. So those fields we will be getting, and the new table name would be given as whatever name we define here. And after this definition, we can directly use this table as other tables, and like perform operation, join and all that, whatever we want to get. So these were two special cases. And rest is like this source column, search param. These are basically normal thing only. And so till now, anyone has confusion, any doubt?
I have a question actually. Means,
yeah.
What is the basic difference between this PDF service and the report service? I mean, I didn't understand that.
Yeah, PDF, like you want difference according to functionality wise, you are saying?
Yeah, functionality wise.
Yeah, so like most of the these, the common thing is that these services work on configurations. Like for any new PDF requirement, we write a PDF configuration. For report requirement, we write report configuration. So, but like a PDF service, we can generate any PDF for report thing. Like if we want to get data from DB and all that, that is done through report service.
Reporting means there is absence of PDF generation, right? It only generates reports. That is the main purpose.
Yeah.
It just prints that UI in a proper tabular format. It will return the data according to your query. While PDF will just for an entity, for a given JSON, PDF service will just create a PDF, return a PDF for.
Okay. And PDF service will run on Node server, right?
Yeah, it's a Node.
Yeah. And this
report service is
Java. All of our services are Java except PDF.
Okay.
And just for I will repeat these things again. Some things again. Where you may encounter some problem. So, this search name of search param should match with the field whatever we can use in where clause in the query. Make sure that we are able to use that in where clause. Otherwise, it will generate error. And the whatever field we are using in this source column, those should those columns should be written by these queries. So like total, those names should exactly match with the columns written by these queries. Like total is there exactly matching with this total, and message as status, the status is exactly matching with this thing, and and also this this query is without any space or in all that, should be like sometimes when this YAML file is not valid, the report service may throw errors. So make sure that these this YAML file is also valid. And basically, like based on the search param, if user provide any value, so those search param, the value is appended. Those values are appended with these search clauses after this base query. So like and the actual value will be appended after the query. So if there is absence of where clause here, so it might throw error. So make sure you have where clause at the end of this query everywhere.
Could you explain that the second use case once again, please?
Yeah, sorry, can you repeat?
Yeah, you told there are two special cases, right? The second one, could you explain it again?
Yeah, that was inline table. Yeah, so like sometimes if the data is not available in the DB and it is part of MDMS or like where we write JSON files, right? So for example, these kind of data, like static data, whatever is, we want to use in our report. So if we directly on just relying on SQL queries only, so we will not be able to get the data which is not in the DB. So you know that na, this is MDMS data where we defined database using JSON files.
Yeah,
it is not continuously changing. This data is not continuously changing.
Yeah,
this data is this is defined here. So sometimes we want to use this type of data in our report. So basically, if any service is returning something which is not in the DB, or we want it in some processed form, like we are not able to get it directly from DB, that data, so that we can use here, and we can just use columns whatever we want, and it will form a table. And that table we can directly use.
So that service would basically fetch the JSON data, and in the attribute we'll pass which key value param we want, the code and message, and based on that it will map.
Yeah, for example, in this example, although we have message table already there, so in this example they have done like this, so they will search the localizations based on module and tenant ID. So it will return all the it will return objects in this format, ID, code, message, and all that. So we want to make use of only code and message thing.
Yeah.
So here we have defined the key order, and it has formed a new table. And that table we are directly using somewhere here. So like that we can do. Yeah, so here I have defined multi-value thing, and this is free text. So we can make any column, any of these parameter mandatory or non-mandatory also. And some, if we want to like change the path where we want to keep the report, that those things we can change in that action item here. Like some, if we want to get keep this in trade license folder, we will change it to PT and all that. PT, and it will be shown into the PT folder. And here this parameter we don't have much option. So this is like based on the report only. So whatever, when the whenever the user clicks on the link shown in the side menu, so where so that link will go to report front end web page. So for that we have this defined format only, like module name here and the name of the report. So this is not much configurable, but this path is configurable, like where we want to show. Like if you want to move a report inside this to some other folder, like here we want to keep. So like in that case, we will just give the path reports here and not use this PT dot trade license report. Only directly report we will write, and it will go into that folder. So this was one configuration for side menu. And other was for basically allowing the metadata call. Metadata call for this report. So here the name of the report will come, whatever report we are showing. So this is just basically to allow the user from front end to back end. It will, through this configuration, Joule will allow request coming from the user to report service. So this is just for back end access to back end API call to report service. And the first one was for this side menu thing. So for both of these action menu item, we will give access to suitable role here. So based on the role, we will give access. So if he's not given, if any role is not given access and he tries to access these things, he will get error that he's not allowed to access this report. So for any new report, we just have to add two entries, one for action menu and the other for metadata call. The data call will, for data call, we don't need to provide any action menu, because for that the URL is fixed. Like we are not, the report name is not part of URL, so just that data get call. Only there would be one entry only for complete report service for data, any data call. And for metadata call, because the report name is part of the URL, we need to provide, we need to write a new entry in Accent menu for any new report. So basically, there we need to write two Accent menu for any new report and give suitable. We should give access to suitable roles for any report.
Yeah, so I just want to summarize once, like how much I have understood is, like suppose if we want to create a new report, right? So first we'll add the menu, we'll apply this. To adding the menu, we'll map the URL, right? First, so in the menu tree where we want to place the link, right?
Yeah,
that will be the first step. And the second step is the creating the metadata service. So that metadata, what it does exactly? It will hit the backend and what will get, like, does it only provide the authorization for that user, whether he is able to make that call or not? Is that it?
No, actually metadata call, like I said yesterday also, like this is used to draw this box, like what are the allowed search params for that report to the user. This information from this search panel.
That information will be populated there.
Yeah. So based on these information, frontend will draw this box.
And once we click on search,
there would be data call. And based on the data call, the array of rows will come here.
So that data call, where is it mentioned? Like where we have to map it? On the click of search?
No, it will, the front end will automatically get this report name, because it is already on this report base. It will send this, I will show you the call.
Can you just show one report also?
Sorry? Hello?
Sorry, you want to see one report?
You want me to zoom a bit? Hello?
Hello? I just wanted to see what will happen after the search. That report will be generated, right?
Yeah.
I think whatever you are seeing there, that itself is a report.
This is the report, yeah. So we had defined these columns in that report.
And generally, one more question is, in the application, when do we refer it as a report? Means any listing that will happen, that listing is what is referred to as report, right?
Yeah, basically, whatever, if you want to show any data from DB,
So whatever requirement client has, like however they want to monitor, means they will let us know what aggregation level they want. Accordingly, then we provide them with reports.
Correct. If there, so any listing. So when there is a listing kind of a thing, we generally write reports, right?
Yeah. Correct.
Okay.
Yeah, so this is the result of the search. So I will show the call that we had made. So here we have sent the report name and search parameter we didn't fill, so it didn't send in search parameter. And as part of result, it will get this column information, header, this report header, and in report data, it will get the exact data. So there were two rows. So there are two entries in the report data. So like in the same order, they are drawn here, and since for some of the columns, we asked for total also, like mentioned in this config. Source column, total true, total true. Wherever we have mentioned, the total will come also come for those columns. This is the response we will be getting data call in the report. And this is the metadata call.
One more question. Anything that does not come here in the report section, suppose if you have to list the list all the employees, so will it be written in the report service itself or
like you want to show the count of employees?
No, the a list of employees, say employee name and his designation or his attributes, we want to list it like this and it does not come here in the report section as such. So anything apart from this, do we write it in the reporting service itself or
like I'm not getting, if you want to show the that data, we can use the user table to show user information.
If you want a new service, is it?
So we can write config report config. So one new tab will come here on the left hand side where you can check the employee register.
No, I'm just trying to understand that if there is anything like listing. See, reporting is you get lot of details from the backend and you show it.
Yeah.
And if that does not fall under the actual category of report.
Mm-hmm.
It is not called as report, but actually it is a listing of some information, say.
Yeah, like yesterday we were seeing in workflow inbox, inbox where there were listing of all the license.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah.
So if you take the same example, like mm-hmm. listing of all the applications in the workflow.
Yeah.
Will that be written in the reporting service or?
No. So, we already have search APIs, right? And then UI component will display it in that form. We don't need reporting service for.
Okay. One more question is, if we, why are we not displaying it the same way as the other service? We can simply call one service and we can simply display these kind of reports, right? Why are we having a separate
actually this is like state level thing, like every state will have their own requirement for different reports, so we can't like write separate services which return separate fields, right? So that's why we have created this report service. So if some states wants to display some particular fields, we will just edit the configuration, report configuration.
Yeah, also okay. Also one more thing, like in report thing, we are not we don't have much control over this UI part, so it is
okay.
Just based on the config, like we are just adding these fields and columns. If we want more control, then the separate code.
Okay, generally, okay. If a new reporting service has to be written, if a new report has to be generated, we just write the configuration files and we don't write anything in the UI.
Yeah.
And for the other stuffs like application listing for the in the workflow management, all we have to write the code for UI, right?
Yeah, so they have some reusable UI component.
Okay.
They use those components, I guess. I'm not exactly sure how it works, but you they will have KT session, I guess.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, so any more question?
Not from my side, Queen. Actually, can you, one thing is that we don't have the local setup ready, okay? And in the starting, Omkar was telling, right, at 4 o'clock we are having the meeting. So by that time, can we get the Ego micro playground service, as Elson was telling, like, so that we can check the setup, how the things are working, do some demo before next session?
Okay, okay, sure. So we will just share the credential, login credentials for that. So that's all you will require, right? A login credential and a URL.
Login credential, in that case, we will be able to see the flow, right?
Yeah, yeah, sure. We'll share.
Okay. Okay. And what about if I want to see the some PDF generation and that part?
So you just open the network tab and you can see those API calls, right? You can just copy the call and then input in your Postman and check if
okay.
you want to change something.
Okay.
Yeah. So this local setup, you can also do by pointing to playground if you want.
Yeah, that's right. So if you can provide that.
Yeah, yeah. I will just quickly share my screen once. So I will just show how I've done it for Tread license service. You can just follow the same thing.
Okay.
So you guys must have already installed Kafka, right, on your laptop?
Right.
So just first start this Zookeeper and Kafka service. So this is the command to start your Zookeeper server. You can just Google it; it will be there. Otherwise, helping you. And then you just start the Kafka server after that. So one
default configuration will be starting, or something we have to do?
No, no, same. Just
same, default
commands. Yeah, yeah, default. Okay. No configuration. After that, you just import the persister code from the core service. Okay. And the Tread license code from municipal service. You have access to the repos, right?
Right.
Yeah. So just import
service only, right?
Two modules. Yeah. And if you have installed Postgres, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah. Sure. So just create any DB. So let's call it rainmaker-tl, or you can call whatever you want. So just whatever your database name is there, just put it into the Spring data source URL and in the flyway.url. Okay.
Okay.
And just start the persister service. One more thing is this URL path. So if you go to the config folder, so all of our persister and persister indexer, all those configs are there in the config folder.
So this is a private one.
Yeah, these are private ones. So you just have access to the archived one, this open one, is it? Hello?
Sorry, which, any other path is there?
So you have access or not to this repos?
Config one we don't have.
Okay, I will just check with this guy.
Okay.
So either you can just means directly copy paste this file on your local, or just you can put this raw link. So I have just used this raw link here in the persister YAML repo path. Otherwise, you can do whatever Rohit did, right? File colon slash slash and your local path here. So I have just used this repo path, raw path here, and started this persister application. So only two things you have to do. One is the repo paths, and another thing is the DB name here. So when persister starts, you can see here that it has loaded those both configs. These two configs it has loaded. So once that is done, you can then go to TL services application.properties here. So just use the same DB name here also for the data source URL and flyway URL. And after that, if you can see, I have replaced every host with playground environment. So now all of the this all microservices I am referring to whatever are running in the playground environment. So what Gopesh and Rohit were doing were they were port forwarding it. There are two ways. Either you can port forward directly. So then when you hit on your local host, it will go directly to the pod. Else you can go through Zool also, where you just provide a auth token which has access to all those URLs you are trying to access. So I've just replaced all the host with this playground URL. And after that, from Postman, I'm just hitting this localhost 8280 on what I'm running that microservice on my local. So if you see at my request info here, I've added the auth token of a super user because for testing purposes, what we do is on our dev environment, we will map all the URLs to a super user. It won't be in production, but for us to test, it is very easy. Then and you can directly use same auth token to access all the services. And this user info I'm sending because this TL service, which I'm running locally, requires some data from here for auditing. So it will require this UUID and all that thing. So we also have to send this user info if you're running on locally. And for other APIs anyway, it will get enriched by this auth token. So if you see, if I just hit this API, so it's already running on local. And in persisted logs, you can see that it has persisted in DB. So only two things you have to do is, one is change this application.properties, change everything to playground. All the hosts you have to just change to playground. And second thing is just start the Kafka server. So I guess you can get started with this.
Yeah, the only point is we won't be able to get the auth token. Or if you can share the auth token.
Yeah, I will share the auth token, yeah.
Okay.
I will just have a quick chat with Eldan, then I will share the details with you. I will just share the request also and the auth token also, the super user auth token. So then you can access all these APIs.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Are there any
other config file also? In config files also.
Yeah. Yeah. Sure. Config file also. So you just put file colon slash slash and the local path, the whole local path.
Yeah, so you are going to share as a zip file this config file.
Yeah, files. I will share as a zip file.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. So only those two things, if you do, it will start running locally. Means all of our Java apps can be run like this.
Okay. Okay.
Any other questions?
This much only.
Fine, then I guess I will just share those details and you can try local setup. We have anyway another session tomorrow. There then whatever queries you guys have, we can figure out and dive deeper in this customization, like how to customize the service.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
So next the server is Wildfly, right?
What?
Server for Java application.
So it's currently I am pointing to a playground server. We have one playground server. So you guys can point to the same server to just check your local setup.
Actually, it's a microservice, so it's inbuilt here. Srikant.
Okay.
Sorry. What was your question? A Tomcat server you were asking?
No, actually, he considered as a OPPC stack, so he was asking like Wildfly server in that way.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
So Omkar, hello.
Anigan.
Yeah. So should we know?
Are you guys done? So just wanted to check, Vipin, any feedback, questions, open items.
No, as such, it's good only. But the thing is, we want to do the like our own some practice. So if you can share the config files and auth tokens, sorry. Auth token specifically.
Yeah, we'll share the API which generates the auth token. You can use
that. Okay. Then.
Yeah, but before that, I think the infra needs to be set up, right? Which environment?
Agreed. But like being a part of engineering team, like it's going as a dry run and becoming hard to like hook up everything.
So Omkar, Elzan suggested sharing the playground details. So I guess we can.
So token only if you can share so that. For that 1 or 2 hour, we will be able to access the services.
So that will.
Let me. Yeah, sure. Let me discuss with her, and I'll get back to you on this within.
Okay.
Also, did you guys cover the local setup part?
Yeah, I showed them how to set it up, so they can try. Then in tomorrow's session, we can see if any queries are there. We can resolve.
Okay. So the payloads and all, they're there on Confluence, Aniket, or do we need to share them separately?
Yeah, documentation wise, they will be there, but I will still share the TL. Hello.
Yeah.
So I will share this whatever. So for locals, to run it locally, you have to send some extra user info. So I will just share this two APIs which. They can like play around with this two ones and TL create and TL search for.
Are these baselined anywhere? Do you guys use any internal repository or anything to contain them? Yeah, everyone has these set up locally only.
No, everyone has this set up locally.
Okay. Cool. Chalo. So next session is at 2, right? Next session is on customizing front end.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you share this recording also?
Yeah, I'll do that. I'm already on that. I'll share the recordings as well. I'll do that.
Specifically today's, because we will be trying.
We are going to share all the recordings. Don't worry. We'll be sharing all the recordings.
Right.
Chicken. Okay. Chalo. Thanks. Bye.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you guys.
Thanks, Aniket, Gopesh. Thanks, guys.